Okay, good afternoon, everybody. It's really a pleasure for me to be in front of you in order to present you how we qualified nuclear cable. I work for Nexans Group, and I will show you an overview of the process and the different steps. And at the end of the presentation, if you have any question, please let me know. So first of all, I will present you Nexans Group in the nuclear industry. I won't make a commercial slide, but it's just in order to give you the context. And since how many times we manage and we manufacture a nuclear cable, then I will show you roughly what is the cable design, the different part of the cable. Then what is the specification in the nuclear environment, and what is the particular environment. I will follow with the consumption of cable, since the customer specification requirement to the qualification with the different step. Then I will show you a short illustration of the different types of cable that we can use in the nuclear market, and then the conclusion. So Nexans is a nuclear industry. In fact, we began to manufacture nuclear cable since the 80s for the French nuclear market. Our main customer is and was EDF, Électricité de France. We supply the different reactor and nuclear plant in France. In fact, in the 90s, we follow EDF and project from EDF to other countries than in France, in Europe, for instance. And today, that means we are in 2020. That means we, since more than 40 years, we manufacture nuclear cable for different customers, as for example, the well-known are EDF, Framatome, Areva is the old name, Westinghouse, General Electric, etc. So some kind of project that we manage in Europe. The red point are the Nexans plant or offices, but in fact, we follow our customer in the worldwide, in Bulgaria, Czech Republic, France, of course, in Canada, Brazil, Indian, etc. I will show this map because you will see with the different countries, with the different nuclear authority of safety nuclear, we can have different specifications. That's why I show you this. Now the cable design. I think you know it, but I show you here the different parts that you can find in the common or general cable. You have, first of all, the conductor. The conductor can be made in copper, aluminium, tin copper, or silver also. After, you have the insulation in PVC, cross-link polyethylene rubber or silicone. There is some other kind of raw material, but the main are here. For instrument and measure cable, you can have also braid, mainly made of copper or tin copper, and the outer sheath in PVC, but for nuclear market, we used to make it in XLPE, for instance. The rules of each part is show here. The conductor, of course, it's for the conductivity in order to transmit signal or voltage and current. The insulation is permitted to avoid contact between each conductor and also with the environment. You can have also the braid, it's for electromagnetic protection. And the outer sheath is like our skin, in fact, and that it permits to protect against mechanical treats or and to give chemical protection. Now, what is specific on the nuclear area? Here you have a scheme of a nuclear plant, and there is three main parts. In fact, the first part and the most critical one is the nuclear reactor, where you are the reactor here and the primary water from the reactor, and here you can have radiation. So according to the EDF specification, you can have K1 and K2 cable. I will show you after what's the difference between both. In fact, K1 is cable that have to withstand radiation accident. If there is an accident, the radiation will be higher than usual, and the cable have to withstand such radiation. You also have K2. K2 cable are less critical, but they have to withstand also aging radiation. And both cables are classified, safety classified in nuclear. And you have to take in account that you have 100 kilometers of such cable per reactor. In the second part, you have the turbine hall and the cooling tower. In this part, it's non-classified cable because there is no radiation, and it's not the most critical part of a nuclear plant. You can account 2,000 kilometers of cable per unit for this area. And between both, cables that permit to make the link between two areas, you have safety cable, but without radiation exposure. So we call it K3. It's more or less 1,000 kilometers per unit. And on this cable, you only have to show that the cable can withstand 60 years at 90 degrees. I will explain this you after. And this requirement of the nuclear area give a different specification, and so different design in the cable. And so the design and the construction will be directly linked to the specification. So now the construction of cable. Here you have the five main steps of the conception and the qualification of the cable. You have the customer specification or market specification. You have the development of the design of the cable, and also the development of the raw material use, mainly like compound, insulation, outer sheath, bedding also. You have after the creation of sample that permits to make real the prototype that you design on the paper, and after to make the test and at least the qualification. For one qualification of cable, it takes more or less between one and two years for these five steps. And I suggest to you to follow all these steps with a concrete example, and to follow, for instance, the EDF specification that is named CST 74C06A. That is a specification from EDF, Électricité de France, for the nuclear cable. I come back to the slide with the different projects that you can have on the worldwide. Here, I just want to make a comparison about customer specification and market. And this table, I will show you in order that you take into account that even for same nuclear plant, but not the same design of reactor, it can give a different specification. Specification are directly linked to the customer, of course, but the type of reactor and also the nuclear safety authority. For instance, for the French EPR reactor, and I give you also a comparison with the Russian EPR reactor, the lifetime is the same, 60 years at 90 degrees. Why 90 degrees? Because it's the maximum temperature of the conductor. So we put on the worst case, 90 degrees maximum temperature, and during all the life of the nuclear plant, that means 60 years. So the aging time for such need is 10 days at 135 degrees for EDF. But for instance, for Russian EPR reactor, it's more than 1,400 hours at 150 degrees. After that, we have to test also the cable from to the irradiation. For EDF, it's 250 kilogray for the K2 cable. It's aging radiation. And in case of K1 cable, that means accident radiation, it's 850 kilogray. And in front of that, for the Russian EPR reactor, it asked that our cable have to withstand for K1 and K2, it's 500 kilogray. And for the K0, there is a higher level, I would say, it's one megagray of radiation. And after, I will explain it to you after, we have also the LOCAST test. In fact, the LOCAST test is to simulate an accident in the reactor. When you have it, an accident in the reactor, the pressure will increase suddenly with a higher temperature. In order to simulate it, you put the cable in autoclave, like cooking pressure, and the test has to withstand this test and this environment. And so for EDF, it's one peak at 156 degrees, 5.6 bars. And for the EPR reactor, is 1 hour at 50 degrees, and 5 hours at 207 degrees. And the pressure is 5 bars. So according to that, design of reactor, different specification. And so we have to answer to it and to comply of it. So if we come back to the EDF specification, for instance, the EDF specification says that each part of the cable have to comply with the specification. The conductor, we have to follow a standard. The material for instance, for insulation have to be low smoke material and zero halogen material. It gives also the mechanical properties of insulation, the insulation resistance, and the lifetime, as I explained before, 60 years at 90 degrees. Also for the material of the braid, you have to be copper with 80% of overage of 80% of coverage, linear resistance maximum. And for the outer sheath, the same. The material have to be low smoke, zero halogen, mechanical properties, insulation resistance, etc. You have also in the same specification properties on the complete cable, the frame retardancy of the cable. For instance, the cable have to be low smoke. You have also to be conformed to a bending test, etc. And that means you have also a specific requirement, as I explained you before, the lifetime demonstration with the Arrhenius law. We have to show that we can withstand 60 years at 90 degrees. I'll show you in the brief slide here. In fact, with the Arrhenius law, we make in oven at different temperature raw material. We test the mechanical resistance of these raw materials, and when it decreases after 50% of the initial elongation at break, we stop the test and we get 1 point, and we do it for several temperature, and with the Arrhenius law, we can predict the lifetime of the raw material. And so, thanks to that, we can show that we will withstand 60 years at 90 degrees, the lifetime of the nuclear plant. For the key to cable, we have the edging radiation. So here, the edging radiation, in fact, have the same mechanism as the thermal edging. That means we have the some radicals. It creates some radicals, and it it breaks some polymer line. And in fact, the just in order to give you an idea, 5 gray, only 5 gray is a lethal dose. That means with 5 gray, you can have some trouble and can it can provoke the death. And in fact, key 2 it's 250 kilogray, and for key 1 it's 850 kilogray, just in order to give you a scale. Sorry, back. And then for the key 1 cable, as I explained you before, you have the LOCA test. So what is a LOCA test? LOCA test, it's an autoclave. You have the picture here when you can have temperature and also pressure. We put steam inside. We can go until 20 bars. It's our equipment. We have such a machine in our factory, so we can manage quite easily a different kind of test. And here you have the profile of the CST, where you see the first peak, it's 156 degrees with a sudden increase of pressure and temperature. And you have the time here also. And we have to follow all these phases in order to, and after we test the cable, insulation resistance, etc., in order to be sure that our cable for the key one qualification will be okay. So, sorry, back. So now, design of material and the design of material and the cable. Here, we will make the reflection of the design of the cable. Which design the cable have to be in order to be conformed to the specification? Dimension, thickness. If we have also the compound to comply with a different requirement. If yes, we test it. If not, we develop new material. It's the case for that we have to do today for the Chinese project. And after, when we have developed the compound, we design the cable thickness. What will be the process on the line where we can do this type of cable, and what should be the electrical properties that we should have. Then you have the samples. Here it's very critical phases, and it's one of the most important because it permits to check different points. First of all, the processability. Because if you have a cable in our mind, you make a test and you see that it's not industrialable, okay, it's a good cable, but only on the paper, not in reality. So this permits to check the processability of the cable. In which line you can produce it in terms of compound, branding, assembling. It's also permit to check all the dimensions that you expect, thickness, dimension of braid, etc., and to forecast the industrial process and to have an idea about the cost also. And it, of course, if you have some issues, some problem, it permits also to see if you will have some trouble in the future in the industrial process. Then you have the test, different tests to do, electrical test, mechanical test on the sample, and to be sure that when you will present the cable for the qualification, that all the steps will be conform. Then the qualification. The qualification have to be in another laboratory, in a third party, or a third party, a person from notified body like Bureau Veritas can come into the plant, for instance, and to check and to witness the test and to be sure that the test that we do it in the right way with the right equipment in order to certify our test. And after we make a kind of report and we send it, in this case of in EDF, we send it to EDF in order, and they read the report and they check if all tests is conform or not. And on this report, we will put chemical, mechanical test, lifetime calculation, the edging, the edging of the cable, the irradiation report also, and the local report. And we submit it to EDF, and for instance, EDF or the Nuclear Safety Authority give their accreditation for saying yes, okay, according to that, we can say that you can manufacture cable with a CSC qualification. And by this way, we can today we have several types of cable qualified. We can have in nuclear plants, you can have four main types of cable. The medium voltage cable from 1.8 to 3 kV until 8.7 to 15 kV. It's for turbine, electric generator. For the power pump, electro valve, etc., you can have also the low voltage cable. I give you here common design for this. Then you can have control cable and measure cable. It's more signal cable. So that's why you can see there is a braid for electromagnetic protection. Control cables are linked, are connected to for control and signaling, and for measure cable, it's more for sensor. So in conclusion, so Nexans is a specialist in a nuclear cable because we manufacture cable since more 40 years. Nuclear cable are mainly composed of three main parts: conductor, insulation, and sheath. Nuclear area is very hard area. Radiation, we can have pressure, temperature, so that means it's a specific qualification. And these specifications are directly linked to the type of reactor and the customer need and the safety nuclear authority. And for the qualification, from the conception to the qualification, we have to follow the five main steps that I showed before. Thank you for your attention. If you have any question, please feel free to ask.
So maybe I can start.
Yeah.
I would like to ask you, because you have showed us the procedures that you use, that actually the companies are using for the qualification of for European pressurized reactors in France and Russia.
Yeah.
Those procedures are depending. They are dependent on the insulation of the cables, or just because of low voltage cables.
I'm not sure to understand your question. Is
those procedures, for example, apply the LOCA?
Okay. Yes, it's on the complete cable. So that means the insulation have to withstand it, the outer sheaths also, okay. All the complete cable.
So it is not dependent on the type of the insulation that you are putting inside?
No. It's really a complete cable that we test. So for sure, the outer sheath will protect it. It will avoid that water. In fact, in the LOCA test, you have boric acid. Boric acid is why? Because when you have a reaction in the reactor, the bore permits to stop the reaction. And so in LOCA, you have also boric acid. And so the outer sheath give a protection. But for sure, after if you see it, yes, after such time, the authorship will not be it become permeable. Uh-huh. So the water and the water due to the steam go into the insulation. And so, in order to avoid this, we put for key one cable internal sheath in order to give more protection to insulation.
Okay, so you're mainly testing up the sheath to investigate if actually you can have the permeation.
Yes, yes, exactly. But in fact, in such test, we test the complete cable. So every part of the cable have its rule, and so permits to pass the test. But the main protection in this case, it's clearly the sheath. And that's why we put internal sheath for the key one cable where we have this kind of test and not for the key two or key three, because we not have this test, so it's not necessary to put internal sheath.
Regarding the local test, yeah. Is it important to have the banding inside the autoclave?
Yes, because in fact, when you install the cable, you give a kind of recommendation. In our data sheet, we say how cable have to be installed with minimum bending radius. Because if you do like this with the cable, for sure, it will appear some cracks on the outer sheath. So, for instance, yes, exactly, you're right. For instance, for our cable, nuclear cable, we say not lower than 10 times the diameter. If you install it at 5 times the diameter, it will appear some cracks. And in this case, it's not our fault. It's a problem of installation. So that's why we follow this. We are in the most critical case where the diameter of this it should be 10 times of the diameter, like we can have in the most critical installation, and we put it in the autoclave. And also because for the insulation resistance test you need to have 15 meters. So 15 meters it would be difficult if you do not make this kind of, yes, exactly.
Yeah, yeah, sure.
Yes?
I have a question on this slide. The profile that you show here.
Yes.
You have first shock and second shock. And first accident. Is it representative to a local accident?
Yes, it should be. Yes. In fact, this profile comes from the CST and the RCCA. That is the common specification for nuclear, mainly in Europe. You have different standards, but for many in Europe. So yes. It should be the most critical reaction that you can have in a reactor.
Okay, so the most critical. I was wondering about the 156 degrees C. Was it the precise value?
It comes from the simulation that have been made in a reactor, because in a reactor, when you have a reaction, you can have very sudden increase of temperature and increase of pressure. And it was calculated that the maximum temperature that can be reached, it's for the French EPR reactor, it's the 156 degree with such pressure.
And decrease and increase, what does
in fact, because when you spray boric acid, it will stop the reaction. And in the case if there is another kind of reaction, you can you have an ulcer, the second shock. As I know.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
And my question, last question, is there any radiation during this kind of accident or?
In fact, we make radiation, and after with the same cable we do this test. In fact, it's maybe it's not obvious in my presentation. It's sequences. We make edging with the same cable. We make the radiation, the irradiation test, and with the same cable we have such test. In other, always the same thing. To simulate an accident in the reactor, you have what? Radiation, pressure, temperature. It's not possible to do it in autoclave in the same time, so we do it separately. You're welcome.
And after each aging phase, you measure all the properties of the cable. I mean,
yes.
Physical properties to check if there are deviations.
Yes. Yes. Exactly. And in order to understand what happened and what we have to do in order to be sure to be conform regarding the qualification, because if we test it just at the end, we will not know if it will come from the LOCA test, yeah, the deviation, or from the radiation. We after each test we make insulation test, etc., in order to be sure that we are conform, and at each step we make control, and even for the qualification with a third lab in a third laboratory or a person from the notified body, they will be there at each step, and the control will be done at each step also.
You measure also elongation at break on some pieces of samples?
No. It's mainly mechanic. It's we make insulation resistance. And also, for instance, we put it in water in order to, yes, be sure if there is some micro cracks that is, yes, not obvious. And if you make insulation resistance in the air, you can pass the test. Yeah. But if you do it in water, no, for sure no. Yes, please.
I would like to ask about the comparison. See, there is a table of French, yeah, PR and Russian PR. So I was wondering from where do you have these numbers, or like what does it mean, Russian EBR? Because it's like BVER or?
Yes, it's BVER, exactly.
And the numbers are from where? It's like the worst condition, the worst location in the power plant, these numbers, or from where?
Yeah.
Is it from some standard? Like is it RCCE for French and for Russian it's different standard, or compare other numbers?
Yes, yes, it's not the same standard. For instance, it's RCCE for French EPR reactor, and for the VVR, for instance, it's EE383.
Okay.
So it's not the same standard. And in fact, the person that for the VVR reactor, you not have the same specification because the requirement is not the same. In this case, they think and their calculation that they have made said, okay, in the most critical situation, we can reach not 156 degrees, but more 250 degrees. So the cable have to withstand such test.
And do you have some cables in some Russian power plant?
Today, for instance, for this reactor, we last year we have the contract for the four new nuclear plants in China, Tianwen 7 and 8 and Shudapu 3 and 4, and the design of the reactor is a VVR reactor. So we are in the qualification progress for such reactor.
But I guess it happens only outside Russia. Inside Russia, they have their own cables, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
No. Yeah. They have their own made. Yeah. You're right. It's difficult to send our product in the Russia market, because they have their own product, their own market, and own manufacturer, and so it's difficult for us to install and to win a contract in Russia, but in fact in China, how it works, they want to build a nuclear plant, so they ask for which which type of reactor they can install, and so they follow the if they want to install a VVER reactor, they ask to the design institute, Russian design institute, the specification, and the specification we receive it, and we see if we can be conform or not to this specification. So it's a Russian EPR reactor, even if it's installed in China, in fact. And in the same nuclear plant, you can have several kind of reactor. For instance, for the Tianwan 7 and 6, sorry, not 7 and 6, but 5 and 6, the 5 and the 6 reactor in the same area, it was EDF reactor. It was one of the, it was an EPR reactor, but the old, just very close to the, to in the same era, very close to this reactor, you have two new EPR reactor, but with VVER design. You're welcome. Yes?
You talk about the 60 years of lifetime. What happens after 60 years? Is it also possible to requalify cables, or what happens then?
In fact, today, yes. Today, the cables are designed for the 60 years, 90 degrees. And so normally you have to replace the cable. But you know, there is some change. If the technology and the kind of project as today, like Team Cable, show that we can predict, and with a small analysis of the cable, and we can predict the rest of the lifetime of the cable, maybe it can change. But today, after the 60 years, you have to replace the cable.
Okay. That could be a lot of work, I imagine, to replace all the cables in the power plant.
Yes, but you know, even if our cable warranty, I would say, or designed for the 60 years at 90 degrees, in fact, you have some pieces that is already replaced because you change the equipment, and so because of the change of the equipment, you have also to change the cable, etc. So in fact, you will not replace. On one day, you have not to replace all the cable in the nuclear plant.
Okay. And one more question about that. You talked about the gamma rays creating the degradation of the cables. Is there also other types of rays that could lead to damage of the cables? Or is it especially gamma?
Okay. This slide?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, gamma radiation aging.
Yes.
Is there also some other kind of aging due to kinds of radiation?
No. In fact, this picture was in order to show that there is in the CST standard for Electricité de France, or for other kind of specification, you have two kind of, it's the same radiation, but you have standard radiation in the reactor.
Yes.
But you have to take in account that also you can have an accident, and in this way it's not the common dose rate of the radiation, but very high dose rate. And even if you if the cable was designed, for instance, for 250 kilogray, they have to withstand also the 850 kilogray in case of accident. So that's why in this slide, you have accident radiation here, but the rate point, if you have, imagine the cable is installed in a nuclear plant since 60 years, no problem. So that means you have aging due to the common radiation, and the last day, the last minute, you have an accident. So that means in this case, you have also the accident radiation. And in this case, it was calculated that you have to both aging radiation plus accident radiation, it's equal to the 850 kilogray.
Okay, so you look at the total of that.
Exactly.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome. Another question? No? Okay, thank you.
Thank you.